What's up, everyone? This is Ken here from Probably Stories. So last Monday, the Prime Minister Tan Sri Muhyiddin Yassin has announced the Pumalay stimulus package, about 150 billion right now. And the highlight there, of course, is the 6 months loan moratorium, unconditional. No need to give any documents, no need any reasons. Everybody is eligible as long as you opt in. As of now, they only mentioned that the moratorium is going to be application is going to open on 7th of July. So please, all of you, please sit down, sit tight, wait for the announcement on the website and terms and conditions on the website of your respective banks. No need to call your banker and break their phones, okay? So as of now, the credit facilities, credit card has been confirmed not to be in the moratorium list. But however, if you do need assistance, the banks is offering that you take the outstanding balance of the credit card and convert it into a term loan with lower interest and also the increased tenure. And today I want to give a little bit of my thoughts on this moratorium thing, especially in terms of mortgage as an investor, okay? Or as a property agent, if you will. The first thing first, who should you take a moratorium or not? If you are an investor, I would suggest that you take. Especially if your unit is vacant right now, why would you take? If your unit is also tenanted, please take. That extra cash you can use for contingencies. Like for example, things like skid repairs. You don't know what are the things that you need to do in the next 6 months. You could use that money, that 6 months installment that you're going to pay the property to gain higher returns for an investment. That mortgage is so cheap. It's only like 3%, the less than 3%, some of the rates, some of the banks. Why wouldn't you take that out and then find investment instruments that can give you higher than 3%? I presume as an investor, you will be able to find easily things, instruments that will give you more than 3%. So take that out and use it. But Kenny, how about taxes next year? I'll be paying more taxes. Yes. Before you do that, you could weigh taxes. You should weigh that. Is you take out and the investment return, can you beat the amount that you need to pay for taxes? That is the calculation that you need to do. And you can do it now before the loan application moratorium come out. As of today, as of this recording, we do not have details on how the moratorium is going to be done. But it's safe to say it's going to be like something like last year, copy from last year, copy paste from last year, where they're going to charge you interest, but there's no compounded interest. Okay? The next category is those who have lost their job or experienced a reduced income. Please take it. This one goes without saying. Okay? If you need to pay longer a bit, so what? You need to survive at this moment. Please take it, use for daily expenses, and use it as to buffer up your emergency cash while you find something to do. Or get a new job. Next one is that if you are own stay property, that's own stay, you have a choice. For me, I personally, even if own stay, I also will take. I don't mind paying, stretch the payment to longer. Because why? Because if own stay, I can take their money, maybe park it to standby, fix deposit or something like that, to put their money in case next 6 months I lose my job. I don't know. I lose my job or maybe my salary get reduced, or worse, maybe there's a company restructuring and my boss don't like me and then I'm very stressed up. Okay, I got my house to pay, I got family to feed, so I will take that money, put it in a safe place like a fixed D. I don't want to take so much risk with that. That is an emergency money to me, and in the event anything were to happen, I want to be able to pay for that house that I'm staying. Okay, if I want to take more risk or not, I will take it on my investment property, not my own stay property. At least I have a roof over my head or rent I can pay. The last category, the self-employed business owner, those people doing their own business or freelancers. If you are paying your housing loan, please take. This goes is a no-brainer decision. Please take for emergency, because having a cash in hand, at least you will be able to sustain. Because there's really very, very uncertain out there at times. We don't know when is our next meal going to come. We don't know when the business is going to come for us. So you might as well take the moratorium, save it, and use it wisely. or if you are in the capacity to take that moratorium, explore new businesses, explore, learn new skills. Perhaps you can learn how to optimize your Facebook ads. That's what I'm doing right now. And you can actually learn how to do video editing. You can pick up new skills that will help you to either get better at what you do or completely pivot out of that industry you're in. Okay? So use these 6 months wisely. Next one we're going to talk about is this higher purchase and personal loan. From last year, right, from what I understand, because higher purchase is they will extend your tenure for 6 months. Okay? Let's just say you have 30 months left to pay, then see you 6 months off, right? So month 31st to 36, you off. You continue from 37 onwards. So instead of finishing at maybe 3 years, you finish at 3 years and 6 months later. They do not charge the extra interest. The personal loan is the same. If this is the case, right, ladies and gentlemen, if this they follow like that from last year, please take the moratorium. There's no extra interest for you. There's no penalty, nothing. But all this, we have to wait for announcement along the way. So by 7th of July, then we can decide whether we want to take or not. But if it's the same as last year, I will highly recommend you to take it. It's money safe. Money safe is still money safe, okay? I think that's all I want to share with you, my personal take on the loan moratorium. I hope it helps. And along the way, maybe next time when I get more information on calculations, perhaps I can share for those of you who love numbers. I would be happy to break it down for you. And until then, I guess that's all for me today. This is Kenny here from Property Stories. Bye-bye.